Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. Thank you guys for tuning in today. Today's gonna be a very chill kind of vlog. As you can see, I am chilling on the floor of my bedroom in front of my dresser. So over the last few weeks, I have been so consumed and knee deep in planning, organizing, decluttering, starting new projects, and also doing a lot of editing. I've also started homeschooling my son here in Toronto. It has been super crazy. And what's insane is it's already October, and I don't know about you, but this year I feel like has gone by so quickly. In the blink of an eye, we are already in October, and I feel like I have just been trying to get a good grasp of my time, and something that's been really helping me do that is goal setting and planning. You know, time is our greatest commodity, and it's important that we use it wisely, and goal setting helps you do just that. It helps you maximize your time. So today I simply want to share with you guys what I personally do in my goal setting and planning. So if this is the first time you are tuning in, make sure you subscribe to this channel, drop a comment, and continue to watch. All right, so I feel like before we begin the process of talking about goal setting, I really want to be able to create or help you create a firm, solid foundation to start off on, and it's talking about your vision and your purpose. I like to refer to our life to a house and building a house. In building a house, you need to first set a solid concrete foundation. This foundation is very important for the structure and the stability of a home. When you are able to understand what your greater purpose is, or ultimately your vision or the bigger picture, you will be able to create a solid foundation to build a house. And simply the goals that you are setting are the bricks that you are going to build upon the structure, right? So it's really important to start off there. How I've personally gone about really trying to understand what my purpose is a lot of prayer time and a lot of reflection. For some people, it may be the same, it may be different, but it's taken me a long time, a lot of trial and error, really trying to find out or figure out what my vision is, what my goals are, and ultimately the bigger picture. Like said, after prayerful consideration and many years of trying this and trying that, I've been able to find out and home in on what my purpose is. So I'm not sure what that is for you, but I encourage you to start off by meditating and praying upon what you're upon. So I highly encourage that you start off there and take some time on it. This is not like something rush, but this is, like said, that solid foundation so you are able to build a strong, stable house. Ta-da. Why I encourage you to take a lot more time on this part before even goal setting is because life can go by so quickly. It's crazy that it's already October. You and I are sitting here right now, and honestly, time is our greatest commodity, and it's something that we can't take back. So it's important to understand where we are putting our time and energy and where we are investing it. So right now, I encourage you, before you start goal setting and doing all of that, is to take time and think about what your purpose is and pray on that. You know, we oftentimes just go through life doing things on a day to day, and it can become so routine, and little do we take time to sit down, slow down our pace, to try to really understand if this is the right direction for me. So moving forward, where I would like to start off is creating categories. I'll share some examples. Mine would be fitness, family, friendship / community, faith, and career. Those are my top five. I like to start out by creating these categories of things that are important to me first, so then I can have a better understanding of how I can create better goals for, or more specific goals, moving forward after.
Hi guys, I'm Preston. Today I'm going to make hangries with Gray. I have a hiccup.
You have hiccups? Oh gosh.
Bye, Richelle. Bye.
Bye. Okay, lock the door. Hi, let me get my thoughts back together. Once you have written down your categories, now you can begin writing your goals underneath each category. And I encourage you to be very specific. Add a date, add other resources and things you may need to achieve those goals, and make it very detailed. So for example, for mine, for the month of October, I am going to be doing my prayer and fasting for 21 days, which had started this Monday. So let me double check what that date is to be more specific. All right, so it would have started this past October 5th. So October 5th would have been the start date. My end date would be the 26th of October. So I like to be very specific about what I'm gonna be doing during that time on my day, what I'm not going to be doing, and make sure that everything is in detail. When you have finished writing down each goal specifically, I would encourage you to go back and reflect and pray if this is really in alignment with your greater purpose. Oftentimes you kind of just do things out of like a whim, but you have to ask yourself if this is going to actually add on to your future and really create that life that you desire, that dream that and fulfill that vision that you have. So ask yourself if this is truly in alignment. It's good to double check, triple check, even quadruple check. So take your time to do that when you have finished writing out the categories and writing the specific goals under each category in detail. So meditate on that after. So after you have written down your specific goals and have double checked if it is in alignment with your greater purpose and your vision, I would start off by going backwards with your goals. And what I mean by that is taking the time to reflect on where you are right now with those goals and understanding how you're gonna reach that goal. So for example, the easiest example would be fitness. I like to start off here understanding where I am and how I'm gonna reach my goal. For example, by December 30th, 2020, I want to lose 5 pounds. Totally doable. You know, if you put the habits and disciplines into work, let's just say I am 140 pounds. I don't even know how much I weigh. And I want to get to 135 pounds by December 30th. So that's 5 pounds I need to shed. Now I have to understand how I'm gonna get there from here to here. Now that gives me 2.5 months to shed the weight. I like to focus on two things when it comes to fitness, and it's nutrition and also your workouts. For me personally, I would be more specific talking about how I'm gonna go on a caloric deficit. I would probably intake 1200 to 1300 calories per day. So I would go down in my caloric intake, making sure that I'm getting the right nutrients in, that I'm having enough protein, fiber, that my fat consumption is a lot lower. And I need to also monitor how much carbs I'm taking in as well. And I like to track with this app. This is not sponsored, but I love, ooh, is it going? Yeah, okay, I don't know if it's showing. It's called MyFitnessPal. Now that's the nutritional aspect. You can go into greater details. I don't wanna chat your ear off about nutrition. But the other component of reaching my fitness goal or my pretend fitness goal is how many times I would work out a week and what kind of workouts I would do. I would focus on doing a mix of cardio, which would consist of high intensity interval training and also low intensity steady state. So there's two of those kind of cardios. You can check those online, what those are and what options you have. And I would also focus on weight training. And I know we're at home and we may be limited with our equipment, but you can definitely still work out. I'm sure you can pick up a chair or do something. There is some heavy stuff in your house that you can use, okay? Be creative, guys. Be creative in terms of your goals and how you're able to reach it. But that is just kind of a small example of like how you can work backwards. And each week, I would recommend revisiting those goals. Have I been on track? Have I been keeping up with the workouts and eating well? And also, is this working for me? Do I need to amp up my carbs? Because me personally, I realized in the beginning that I needed a little more carbs for energy. And so I had to be okay with that. So try not to get so worked up about it, but also understand how it is important to make sure that you are on track, but also give yourself grace that not every day or every week is gonna be perfect for you, but make sure that you get yourself in alignment, okay? All right, let's do this. Make sure you are checking in with yourself to see what your energy is like, how you are feeling, you know, mentally, physically, and if you are okay, because it's, you don't want to get caught up just in the hustle of like reaching your goal and next thing you know it, like you hit a wall. Give yourself the grace to grow and try again. So now that you have done all of that, I'm gonna challenge you and ask, what can you do today? What can you do right now to start off on your goals? I know oftentimes we're like, okay, I'm gonna start this next week, I'm gonna start this tomorrow, but let's not procrastinate. Let's think about what you can do right now, and it doesn't have to be anything really big. You could maybe, if it's for fitness, go out for a walk, do a little dance and do Zumba. So I challenge you today to take action. Not sure what that is for you. Little things go a long way, and each activity, each decision ends up compounding. It's like building that house. Once again, you're building bricks, and ultimately you're gonna create a beautiful house for yourself. Put your plan and goals into motion today. Even if it's one little decision, I encourage you to do so. Maybe you don't eat that pie or cake. Maybe you do. And if this is your first time, I encourage you to try it out and let me know how it goes in the comment section, or you can find me on Instagram at Karen Sundays. But thank y'all for tuning in to my chatty chatty session. So guys, before I let y'all go, I want to make an announcement that in 2 weeks time I will be launching my brand new project called Join the Table, and you guys do not want to miss out on this. This has personally been something that has been placed on my heart for a little while, and I am so excited that it has come into fruition, and it is going to be dropping in 2 weeks time after Thanksgiving, and it is a roundtable discussion with females talking about faith and our experience and life all together over some really delicious food. So I'm really excited for that. Make sure that you guys tune in, subscribe to our channel, turn on the post notifications so you don't miss out, and I will catch you guys on the next one. Thank you guys for tuning in. I hope you guys have a fabulous Thanksgiving weekend, and I will see y'all on the next one. Bye.